Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to old times. I'm just having a look at the ocean down here, I'm just taking a couple minutes of break, but yes, that's enough of that. So the question that I'm asking for this week is, do you want me to plough the fields prior to cultivating them, or do you want me to just cultivate and then drill? The reason I'm asking is because before 1980, here in Europe, it was uncommon to just cultivate without ploughing first. You would normally have ploughed and then cultivated. I personally would like you to get me to plough and then cultivate, but obviously it is your vote, it is your game. So head down to the comment section below and let me know which one you would like. Would you like me to plough and then cultivate, or just cultivate? I'm just going to fill up this seed drill. I did the top and the bottom headlands on the second field, so I'm just going to go and fill this one up. I think we have a slight bug with this game, in that I pick up these coins every so often, and then they keep coming back. So I think there is a slight bug with that. There was a more updated version of the map, but I couldn't find one on a decent download site, and I kept having to sort of fight my way through all sorts of rubbish. You're probably familiar with that if you've downloaded maps or any mods. So yes, we'll just sort of ignore the coins and we'll pick some up if we pick some up, that sort of thing. I'm not going to try and gather them all, I don't think, because I'm not convinced that it's working properly. So we'll take this one over and we'll get this one going. And then today, our big task that we're doing is baling. The combine is working away in the field and hopefully we'll be able to finish that field with this tank full, actually. I think that tank on the combine should finish that field. So once this field here is done, we're going to need to buy a fertilizer spinner and spread some fertilizer on the field. The only problem is we are minus 230 euros and counting, so I'm not sure how soon we're going to be able to do it. We'll have to see how much money we get for the straw. And we've also got some eggs. We got 10 eggs in the backpack and 4 eggs on the ground, so we could sell those as well. So let that one get going. He's going to plant wheat in there, the same as the other one. Away he goes. And I'm going to run over to... Oh, he's over here. It's just there, the other side of the field. I go... Oh no, there he is. So we are using our Deutsch tractor on this Fahr Baler, and we're going to start baling. Let's just take a quick look at this baler. It is all ready to go. There is not a lot that we need to do. This technically isn't how balers used to be. This was an unusual type of baler, and it was more a buncher. It didn't produce a very solid bale. And I don't particularly like that it is classed as a proper baler. I could be wrong. I could be wrong on his count, but I believe that the more familiar configuration of small balers that we're used to, it did come in reasonably quickly. There wouldn't have been many balers like this. They stored loose straw. These were around for a very short while, and then they moved to the more conventional small baler. So let's hitch that one on. We've got our bale counter and everything else. I think we need to unfold it. Yep, it's got to just move out to the side slightly like that. There we go. It doesn't move out very far. I think it should move out a little bit further than that, but that's okay, we can live with that. Lower the pickup. There we go, and start the baler. Right. It is working. It is doing okay. So let's get going with this. And, right, it's picking up that okay. So we want to do one round around the outside of the field. I'm going to go out of cab for most of this. And because we've gathered up all the straw yesterday, the bales should produce at a reasonable rate. We should be able to get them. And this is the only issue, is that this baler is quite narrow, so I don't know if we'll be able to get all of it. But the bales are coming off. I can go sideways on this. Excellent. Look at that. And they're coming through quite quickly as well. I'm going to try and find at some point a mod for the more familiar type of small baler that most people would sort of be familiar with. I believe there is one. I think there is a Welga baler that you can get. Obviously that is going to be quite pricey, so we are going to have to save up a bit of money if we're going to be buying that Welga. I haven't downloaded the mod yet, and I haven't tried it out, but I have seen a few videos with it being used, and it does look very, very cool. It did surprise me, though. Farming Simulator 15, there have been very few small balers. In 13, there were quite a few different ones, and some people put a lot of time and effort. I'm not driving very straight here, am I? Let's try driving in cab a minute. I want to put the wheel sort of in the middle-ish. There we go. That seems to be doing all right. Yeah, so there were quite a few in 2013, but this one, there doesn't seem to have been that many small bale mods. So I am a little bit disappointed at that, but that's okay. We can live with that. I believe that Welga baler also, you can get a trailer that fits it really well as well, which would also be really cool, so that we don't just have to use the one that we're going to be getting now. And that we've already got. I missed a huge chunk there. I'll have to see if I can gather that up again, but the bales might be in the way for it. So let's move down this row. I'm going to go straight on to it this time. That's going really well. I'm really pleased with this. And then because we gathered them all up, when I tested this out the first time, without the windrows. Sorry, I had to stop for a minute. I was coughing quite badly. So, when I tested this one out on the small windrows the first time, there were hardly any bales on each row, and so it took a really long time to be able to gather them up, which was slightly annoying, to say the least. So this has worked out a lot better. I'm very pleased that we did take the time to use that rake yesterday. And I'm also absolutely delighted with that rake. That Agromet, that was absolutely fantastic. And I'm really looking forward to buying some animals so that we can make some hay for them as well. Which brings me to, future plans. What are we going to do? Because I want to get some cows and I want to get some sheep. And I did, was it on the description for this one somewhere? I think this farm, they sort of reckoned that it's suitable for around about 120 cows, which would seem to be about right, I guess, for like a dairy farm from the 70s. 120 cows wouldn't have been far out. That would have been about a smallish dairy farm. So I will aim for around about 100 cows, I think. But obviously they're quite expensive. They're $2,500 each, and at the moment we're on minus $400. So I don't know when we're going to be able to buy cows. Probably we'll be buying sheep first, and so obviously if we buy sheep, we're going to want to get a mod for a forklift of some sort. And there were plenty of forklifts around, but obviously the only way that we can sell any wool is if we can pick up the pallets of wool. So that is going to be quite important. We're going to need to be able to pick up pallets of wool, so I'm going to have to try and find a mod for that. The sheep aren't that expensive, so that's probably the first animal that we will get. And then when we figured out a way to make a bit more money, we can't do the traditional farming simulator approach of making tons and tons of silage with the biogas and selling it, because we don't have biogas. So what we might actually have to do is do a whole load of logging. We've got our normal crops here that we're doing. I have to drive around that bale there. See if I can get these few bales down here without hooking the bales up on the baler itself. When I come down there, it's just gathering them up. Excellent. There we go. Right. And I've got a few here that I've missed. There, and then I've got a couple of windrows left. I'm not going to worry too much about gathering it up, because whatever you decide with the question, please pick ploughing. Not that I'm trying to influence it. Yeah, whatever you decide, we will sort of cultivate the straw back into the field, so it won't be too bad. But we're up to 143 bales. The trailer that we'll be using in a minute to gather these bales up, that one can gather 50 bales at a time. So we're going to have three loads here in the field. But by the time I empty this one, that will be three loads almost exactly. There'll be more now, because I'm about to make the extra ones. Come down here. Right, I'm not going to worry too much about these odd patches of straw. There's a few up in this in the corner behind us that we can gather up. It's a little bit messy up here, and there's some out off the side of the field that I would like to just scoop up. So we get that. There we go. There's that one, and those up through there. The combine has actually stopped moving. It's not changed at all. So I'm assuming that field has now been finished, which means that we will probably very soon. Okay, I'm going to have to come out round onto the grass here. This is not the way to do this. Swing tight there. Gather that bit up there. So that's neat and tidy. Now this bit in the middle, this doesn't really matter. I will just gather those. Can I get that? I think I can. I'd like to think that I can. If I can swing round that bale there, swing round sharp, like that, and then swing round the other way. So what we'll do is we will unhitch this baler now. Right, we need to stop. Stop the baler, and I will pick up the feed there. And what's the button for... Right, we want to unload the baler, like that. That just makes a little heap of bales. There we go. So we've got 162 out of this little field here. How much is... I think it's 300 litres in a bale, which isn't too bad. I want to fold that one up behind us. There we go. Travel a little better. Come through this way. And I will take this up to the next field. I'm actually going to park it, I think, in that shed there. We'll come out this way to get to it. Oop. I'm not driving very well. I do apologise. I should be paying a little bit more attention to where I'm going. Right. The Hurleyman is at 64... Oh, no, not the Hurleyman, the Bura. 25% CD. Still going. He's going very well. Got no problems with that one. We're going to probably... We should be able to get some of this straw in tonight, but we're getting close to the end of the day. So, as this combine appears to have finished, I'm going to unhitch this one here. So, we'll put that one there, and I'll just drive over to here, and we want to... I'll come back and get this tractor in a second. We want to unload that combine, and where's my tractor? Oh, he's over the other side of this hill. There he is. Oh, there he is. Just down there. So we'll get that one a second. Right, I don't think I'm going to be able to fit all of the tank into this trailer. We won't start combining again until tomorrow now. And we've got... This was the wheat, and then we got the barley to move into. That's ready to cut as well. If we take a quick look at the map. What are the prices doing? Down, 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 down. The only thing that's up is the lucerne, but we can't use that in this game anyway. So we're looking at around 300, maybe 500 for canola. We got nearly 20,000 litres of wheat. So we do have a little bit of money here to come in. I am wondering if I should have put this on normal, because obviously some of the later machines are going to be quite expensive. And I may regret putting this onto hard difficulty. That's all right. We'll figure that out when we get to it. There's got to be ways to make money. And I was actually having a look. I can't remember if I'm repeating myself or not. But there are machines that automatically... I think I said this yesterday. There are actually machines that automatically cut trees before 1980. So we might be able to... I might be able to find a mod that will do that, which means that then we won't have to just use chainsaws for cutting down trees. And I think that the forestry thing is going to be the way that we make our real money in this map. I think that is going to be the key to our success. Because there are lots of trees around. As for a planter... Because we cannot plant them by hand, which is what they would have done prior to 1980, you would not have had an automatic planter. I think we are going to, unfortunately, just have to use a modern planter, because it's the only way that we're going to be able to do it. We're not going to be able to plant them by hand. I don't think there is any way to plant saplings by hand, which is a bit unfortunate, really. I'm a little bit disappointed about that, but... That's all right. Well, that's something we'll just have to sort of live with, I guess. Unless we decide to just not plant trees. We may get away with doing that. Depends how many we cut down, I guess. Well, I'll go and empty this trailer. We've seen this several times now, me emptying the trailers. So I'll empty these, and I'll also bring the combine back to the yard, and then we can get going with picking up bales. The combine and the tractor with the trailers are back at the yard. And I'm now here just collecting this one. This is actually really cool. It is, unfortunately, just a lizard machine. It hasn't been based off any real machine. I don't know if there were actually trailers like this one in particular. I know that there were different bale loaders. You did have various types. You have even some modern ones that just like a conveyor next to a... large trailer. So you do see them even now. There have been all sorts of automatic bale collectors that you are available around the world, and I've seen various videos for all sorts of different ones, but this is the one that we got, and we'll see how much we can pick up this evening. Let me just put this out into the operating position. There we go. And I'm just going to start using this one because we'll run out of time otherwise. I want to try and get as much of this as possible tonight. Now, we just have a look at it a minute. It'll pick it up from the front there. And once it's gathered it, come around that way, it drops it straight into the trailer. Like that. And it just drops them loosely, but it does have a capacity of 50 bales. So it won't allow you to drop more than 50 bales into it. But depending on how fast you move, the bales do move around. So if I break suddenly, it slides them around a little bit. We'll have a look at that in a minute. But you can go at a reasonable speed with this one, picking up the bales. It does do quite well, and it works best, especially now that we did use the windrower and we gathered up the straw quite a bit. It works best just following the line of the baler. So you can just run along. There's actually one spare bale there when we went back over that bit. But that's okay. Come round here. Because our seed drill has finished now, we're going to need to spread fertilizer on that field. We don't have any slurry or manure available at the moment because we don't have any cows to produce any of it. So we're going to have to buy in some fertilizer, and I would like to fertilize them. And on top of that, we've got some crops that are still growing. Let me just quickly show you on the map. This one. Right, so we've got growth. We've got that one. And that one and that one are still growing. These here are all grown. Although some of that is grass, actually. Fruit types. Yeah, grass. We've got a big patch of grass there and there and there. That one's a bit too small for cutting. And we got this huge patch up here. So we got plenty of grass. The ones that are still growing are potatoes, sugar beet, and corn. So we could spread those with fertilizer because none of it had actually been fertilized before we started. So those three I would like to spread with fertilizer, as well as the one that we've just planted. So that, I think, is a job that we'll do tomorrow. Now, we can buy fertilizer when we are in negative equity, but we don't actually have a fertilizer spinner at the moment. So if these bales and the eggs that we've got are not enough to put us back into positive so that we can buy a fertilizer spreader, we're going to have to borrow a little bit more from the bank. Which is a tad unfortunate, because I didn't want to have to do that. Now, if I break suddenly, are those bales going to move? No, they're not going to move. I was hoping that the bales would move a little bit, so you could sort of see that as well. Does that not look absolutely awesome? Let me try just coming onto the tractor a second, so that I can do it from this angle, and see what we can see. That actually looks really cool. I like that. Right, I can get two more bales. I missed that one. We'll have to get that one another time. Come down here and gather that one, and one more. There. No, I missed that one as well. Oh no, I've already got 50 bales, that's why. It's not going to allow me to pick up any more bales. And if I come out of cab a second, I got one bale up there, that's sort of up on the top, but that's okay. So if I... That picks that one up and it folds it back in behind when I press B, so it goes into transport position. So I want to take this back to the yard now, and we can sell the straw, see how much we get for 50 bales. I can't remember. I did actually test it. I tested this thoroughly just to make sure that there was no hitches with the map, anything like that. And I'm really pleased with this thing. I'm pleased with the baler, and I'm pleased with this one. I would prefer a slightly different type of baler, as I mentioned before, but that's okay. We'll go with this. Now, the combine in here, that should have emptied out the last of the grain tank. The bale sell point is in there. Let me just sort this one out. We'll put that away. Where can I put this combine? Will it fit? It won't fit into that shed, will it? It won't fit into that barn. Might fit into there. I don't think we got room for this combine in it. Oh, actually, I think it should fit into one of the barns there. It might just fit in there. If I come out here, we'll try backing it into that one. It does look like some of our bigger machines are going to have to be stored outside. That's as far in as it can go. That's alright, we'll leave it there. Switch you off. Climb out. They're not going to let me out. Okay. Oh. That noise indicates that I have talked for far too long and it is time to stop. So I'm going to leave this tractor right here. I will just quickly unload the last of it there. switch that one off, and I will go back to here and we'll unload this trailer. We can, you know what, I'm actually going to do a bit more of this tomorrow. I'm not just going to say that's it. I will do a little bit more of this gathering of bales tomorrow, because I'm really enjoying it. I think it's making a reasonably interesting video. Feel free to tell me if you don't think it makes an interesting video, but I do. Come around here, and the bale sell point is right there in that gateway. And I have learned that you don't back this trailer right inside the building, because it doesn't like it. It does all sorts of really weird things if you try to do that. And I'm not quite sure what this is. I think that's just decoration. I don't think there's actually any manure there that we can use. So if I back up, and I want to stop in front of the doors. I don't want to go in between the doors because of how it works. Now, what was the unload button? It was O. So I do that, and I'm going to back it up a little bit further now that the doors are open. Unfortunately, it's not actually pushing the bales in far enough. I get 16 euros per bale. And okay, it does look like right, let me if I pull forward a minute, press O. What do I press? Oh, stop unloading is X. Right, let's climb off of here. So we can't pick the bales up by hand and throw them in, which would sort of be more realistic. I can't really push. Yeah, I'm going to have to try and pick these bales back up with this trailer. And so we want to go to operating position. Back it out and oops. Turn the right way here. I should know how to drive a tractor. I've spent enough of my life driving tractors. I should know how to reverse a tractor and trailer by now. There we go. Now, I want to pick up as many of these bales as I can so that I can then back into the shed to it properly. We could really do with a loader, I think. If we could have a loader with a bucket on it, we could just push these in. That would work a bit better. But they're picking up okay. We'll gather all of these up and then we will try and back a bit further in. Hopefully, if I can get in far enough, when the doors of this trailer open, it won't sort of glitch it and go really weird, because it does. It does not like opening those doors. The bales are acting a little bit odd there. I think those last few, we might have to push in. I'm not happy with the way this has happened. Can I get those last? I can get two more. There. I don't think I can get those two. Right, now, let's change this to the loading position. Or, not loading position, the transport position. And I'll bring it up here, and then I want to try and back into that doorway. And I've got to get it right inside, because otherwise the gates on the trailer won't open properly. And it does weird things. It tries to sort of bounce itself right out of the map. There we go. Okay, so I've got to go in like that. Now I should be able to open. If I go right in like that, now I should be able to open it. Like that. You can't see it very well, and you can't go in and see it either, but those gates are now opening properly, and they're selling. Excellent. Right, that's actually worked properly this time, and we are in positive money already. We get 16 euros per bale, and we had 50 bales. So by my reckoning, that makes 800 euros for the trailer full, which is actually really good. That's 800 euros for one trailer of bales. Is that right? Yeah, because 100 would be 1,600 euros. And so 50, yeah, that's 800. So we got 800 euros for that. We will gather up some more. We got two more trailerfuls that we can get tomorrow. And then we've also got fertilizer spreading that we want to do on quite a few fields, actually. And we've got more combining to do as well. But for now, we're going to have to sort of stop for the night. I'm just going to park this one here, actually. This is the ideal spot to stop. So we'll switch that one off there. Yes, that is everything. So, I did go on a little bit today. It's gone on a little bit longer. I do apologise for that. If you enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Remember the question. If you want me to plough first and then cultivate, as would have been probably a more traditional method of doing things back before the 80s, please let me know. And if you would like me to just cultivate, then say just cultivate. Head down below into the comments section. Let me know what you want. It's your vote. It's your game. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.